Is this actually helping with your health, fitness, weight loss? Good morning if you're coming in. If you are coming in, give me a hello. If you're on replay, drop a replay. So what I'm actually talking about here is the stress and the worry about not being perfect, about messing up, so-called messing up, perhaps when we don't even have the data to conclude that we are messing up. For example, do you know the calories of that hot cross bun you had? And did you know it was the same as having two apples? How would you think differently then if you just saw the data? How would you think differently if you took the average weight over the week rather than just stepping on the scales on a one-off once a week, which can then result in us going, oh my God, I've put on 3 pounds, I've been doing everything right, maybe it's my metabolism. Then maybe we go into our metabolism state and we look for certain new diets, new pills, new magic pills, which what do they then result in? Well, they often result in, if I'm honest, perhaps unethical practices from certain diets out there which aim to treat your metabolism or speed up your metabolism, which everything seems to speed up your metabolism these days. So when today, little challenge for you this weekend, when you stress, worry about not being perfect, about not getting this, is that actually helping? Or can you use it as an alarm clock that you need to do something different? And that's all it is. It's just an alarm clock. It's not, I'm negative thinking, I need to stop thinking negatively. It's actually just an alarm clock. Okay, what needs to change? Just change the question. Okay, what do I need to do? What's this saying? What is this alarm clock saying? And we talk about this in our Kickstart as well. When we're trying to change habits, do new things, you might see that there's, and it's good to have an alarm clock. When I catch myself doing this, what could I say? What could I do? Have like almost a habit, a ritual that when you catch yourself doing the thing that you're trying to stop doing, what could you do instead? Okay, next time I find myself stressing, worrying, I'm gonna go to my to-do list and pick one thing off it. Sounds really odd, but action often gets you out of that. Oh, I should do this. And sometimes, yes, going for a walk, exercise. Have you done that? Have you lost your self-care? Have you not focused on the energy 100%? But sometimes we actually just need to do the thing. Do the thing that we're worried about. Like, I've had a hot cross bun in this situation. That's 200 calories. That's the same as two apples. Okay, if I believe that I failed now, what do I do? Well, I binge eat, sod it, start again Monday. If I believe that I've just had two apples, what changes to my response? I'm feeling good, doing really well, got lots of energy. I'm going to have a nice salad for lunchtime. Whatever. You know, our response to a situation impacts the next action. It's all those little yeses and those noes that will essentially impact your results and whether you get great results and something that's sustainable long term, or you just do it in ups and downs, you're either on it or off it, which, let's face it, is just a story to go, I'm giving myself permission to start again Monday. I'm just an all or nothing person. The more we say that, the more we'll believe it. So I hope that helps. Have a awesome weekend. And how are we doing, Danny? How are we doing, Julie? And I'll see you soon.